Hi, it's Janie. Welcome back to my channel. It's been a long time since I have actually seen you guys. I've been doing some other types of videos where you basically just been seeing my hands and hearing my voice and whatever I'm showing. But anyway, so it's glad to actually be seeing you guys. Well, you seen me. You know what I mean. Anyway, if you're new to my channel, welcome. My name is Janie. And I do post videos on Mondays, Tuesdays, and Thursdays. And I do a little bit of everything as far as beauty related, reviews on beauty products, trash videos, sheet mask reviews, and I've started to do some planning videos. So if you're into planning and like planner hauls, from Etsy, sticker hauls from Etsy, you will definitely want to stay tuned because I have a lot of that coming up. And also a little bit of luxury thrown in here and there. So if you would, hit that subscribe button and also hit the little bell icon so that you are notified of all future videos and you won't miss out. So let's get started. Okay, empties, my trash, my beauty trash. This is going to be a little early. I'm filming this, October the 29th? Yes, which is a few days early. I still have a few more days, but I don't foresee me using anything up in the next couple days, so we're going to go ahead and film this and hopefully get this up on time. So, I do have some little cotton. These are the cotton clouds. These are supposed to be comparable to the Shiseido cotton squares, and I do like them, but I think I like the Shiseido ones better. But I had, when I purchased these, I purchased enough for 3 years. I got a lot, so I don't need to purchase any cotton for a little while. But if you're looking for an alternative to the Shiseido, they're a little bit cheaper than try the cotton clouds. Then my favorite cotton rounds, these are the Ulta Beauty Exfoliating Quilted Round Cotton Pads. I like to use this with my toner and every morning and every night. I like them because they have a little bit of texture on the one side, so that I feel like it really helps with getting some of that dead skin off of the face. And definitely will be repurchasing those because I am on my last pack. Oh, here's a new product that my husband and I tried. We have been really enjoying the Dr. Till's Epsom salts, so I've decided to try this foaming bath because my husband does like to take a bubble bath. And this was the coconut oil, and this was really good. We very much enjoyed it, and we'll definitely be repurchasing that. So, did enjoy that. A face spray from Urban Decay. This is the All Nighter Makeup Setting Spray. This is one of the older formula. When I heard they were revamping it and changing the packaging, I kind of stocked up a little bit on these, especially when they started getting marked down, because I really do like this. And from what I've heard, the new one is not the same. I hate it when companies do that. Why mess with something that is not broken? Don't fix what's not broken. But anyway, yeah, I would tell you I'd be repurchasing it, but if I happen to come across it, I will. I've seen the smaller bottles of it at Nordstrom Rack, but not the big bottles. Whoa. Here, come back. Here I am. So, anyway, let me get a drink. We, side note, we quit running our air conditioner 2 weeks ago probably, and it started getting chilly, and my husband yesterday, it was Friday, it was only 50 for a high. Yesterday it was only 50 for a high. Thursday it was 82 for a high. Okay, so on Friday, 50 for a high, my husband's like, don't turn the heat on yet. Okay. So Saturday, he gets up yesterday, he gets up to go to work. He's like, don't turn the heat on. We don't need the heat on yet. Let's try and wait till at least November. I'm like, okay. So he gets home from work yesterday afternoon. And I've been in the house, you know, all morning cleaning and have, you know, a long sleeve on and a jacket and kind of getting warmed up because, you know, I've been moving around cleaning. But anyway, he comes in, he's like, house is cold. So let's turn the heat on. So he turns the heat on. I'm thinking, I have been here most of the day freezing and you're going to come home and turn the heat on. So unfortunately, my camera is sitting right in front of a vent that's up there on the wall. And my microphone is like right there and my vent is like right up there, so you're probably going to hear the heat. I say all that to tell you, you can probably hear my heat running, but yes, it is cold again today for Oklahoma. Yeah, so unfortunately we didn't get much of a break as far as electric goes on, because we try to go as long as we can before we turn the heat on. Anyway, long story. And also, I have two sugar gliders now, and so we had them out in the office, and the office area doesn't get much heat, so yesterday I moved them in to the living room, which is right next to our bedroom. And last night, because when they're in the office, we can't hear them at night, and they're nocturnal, so they sleep all day and up all night. Anyway, and I might have to make a recording of this, because it was so cute. It was very cute at first, but then it started getting annoying. But they bark. They bark at night, and the best way for me to describe it, it sounds like you, if someone was to get like a little Yorkie puppy or a little teacup poodle or a little baby chihuahua, you know, puppies, you know, and they have that little cute little baby bark. That's what it sounded like. And it was so cute at 10 o'clock. But at 1 o'clock, it wasn't so cute. No. And I knew that they do that, but I hadn't heard mine do that, and I didn't realize how loud it is when they do that. But anyway, yeah. So we had two little critters barking most of the night last night, so I think tonight I'm going to have to figure out something else to do with them. But I got to put them somewhere where it's warm. But I gotta put them somewhere where we can't hear them at night. So anyway, whatever. Some vitamins, some sugar hair bear. hair vitamins. Sugar bear hair. That's funny because the sugar gliders, the people that we bought them from, refer to them as sugar bears. So anyway. I really do like these hair vitamins. I think they work. I really do. I really think the combination between this and something else that I'm doing, I think the combination between the two has really, really helped with getting my hair back in shape. One of the reasons why I cut it all off was that the hairstylist that I was going to on a temporary basis, the way she was coloring my hair, it really fried it. And so I had to have it all cut off, and I'm back to my regular hairstylist that knows how to color my hair without damaging it. And between that and the vitamins and then the shampoo and conditioner I've been using, it's getting back to where it needs to be. Then I have a MAC product. This is the cleanse off oil from MAC, and I probably won't be repurchasing. I mean, it was okay. And the only reason why I had them is because I was getting a pro discount, but I don't qualify for the pro discount anymore, so I probably won't be getting as much MAC. And to be honest with you, I really don't think MAC is just all that, to be honest with you. But anyway, it was, if you're looking for a cleansing oil, this would be one to try, or the one from Sephora, the Sephora brand. Those two I do recommend as far as cleansing oils, but I think the Sephora one is probably cheaper. But anyway, so I did finish that. My little pump broke, but I'll be doing a back to MAC for that. There I am. I have an essence, and this is the Snail Bee High Content Essence by, oh, I can't read it, and I don't remember. It's a really good Korean brand, which of course I'll have it right here so you'll see it. But I do recommend products from this company. My friend Annie is the one that kind of got me started with using from this brand. Can you see that? Anyway, so I did use this as my morning serum. It is gone. I don't need to repurchase it because I have so much skincare stuff that I need to get through. So anyway, okay, this guy right here, this was sent to me through Octoly, so I did not purchase it, but I would definitely go out and purchase it. It was a two-part system. So basically what you did was on step number one or phase one, you use this for 2 weeks, for 14 days. And then when you're done the 14 days, then you flip it over and you go to this one for another 14 days. And it's an exfoliating process. So for a whole month, you know, it's a system that you're using to exfoliate. I did find that it lasted longer than a month. So I did phase one for 14 days, and I did phase two for 14 days, and then I flipped it over and I did phase one again, and then I did phase two again. So I got 2 months out of this, and I really, really do think that it really helped with exfoliating. It's called a progressive night peel. It's for wrinkles, pores, and dullness, and it is from Lancôme, which of course we know that's going to make it pricey. So if it's something that you can afford or would want to spend the money, that type of money, on something like this, I would recommend it. I don't know if Sephora carries this. If they do, it might be something to think about getting during the Sephora sale that's coming up. Oh, I have a little sponge that I'm going to get rid of because it is seeing better days. It's starting to crack and peel. I don't know what brand this was. This was an off brand, but I don't know if you're going to be able to see this, but it was laying up against something. You know how these bottles have, you know, the little date codes on them and stuff? And I don't know if you can be able to see that, but on there, something, it was up against something and it imprinted on here. So I have an imprint off of a bottle on my sponge. I can't read it. It just has some numbers on there. So it's done for. And I, like I said, I don't remember what brand that was. I don't think it was a beauty blender. I don't know. Anyway, I personally like the Real Technique sponges the best. So I have another vitamin, and this is called, oh gosh, it's by Quality of Life. I can't pronounce it. Oligonol. Here, let me put it up there so you can see it. Anyway, now, this claims to help with wrinkles, brown spots, and it's supposed to help with cardiovascular health. And it's supposed to help with belly fat. Now, do I think it helps with the wrinkles and all that? I'm not for sure. Does it help with the belly fat? I will tell you that I had taken this bottle, took one every day, and then I was out of it for a few weeks, and I could kind of tell the difference with the way my belly was feeling as far as bloating and feeling a little bit fatter than what I wanted. So I went back to these, and I think for that purpose, I think they work. So I bought another bottle, and I think I'm like halfway through it already. So I recommend them for that, but I would not count on them for wrinkles or for brown spots. If it does, it's going to be definitely long term, meaning that I would probably have to take these for like a year, maybe. I don't know. I have a little product from Caudalie. This was in a kit. This is the Resveratrol eye lifting balm. I didn't really care for it. I didn't feel like it was eye lifting, and I didn't feel like it was very moisturizing. It was a very thin product, very thin. But I did use it. I put it on every morning while I was doing my makeup, but I went and repurchased it. So Then I have a powder. This is from Laura Geller. This is the Balance of Brighten in the Foundation Regular. That I did finish that up. And I'm working on another one. And then I have another one. I don't know how I ended up with so many of these Laura Geller products, but I did. But I do like them. I like to use them as a setting powder. Finish this little sample guy of the Sugar Fresh Lip Balm. This was pretty nice. I don't know if I would, I'm sure this is like a freebie or something. See, it's completely gone. The price of them, I don't think I would purchase them because I think you could get the Dr. Rescue Maybelline Lip Balm that is just as good as this and a fraction of the cost. A little eyeliner from Marc Jacobs in black. And again, this was probably like a 100 point perk or something like that. And I do like this. I do like this a lot. If I didn't have, 50 million black eyeliners, I would purchase this in full size, but I don't need to right now. Have another little small eyeliner, and this was from It Cosmetics. This is the No Tug Waterproof Gel Eyeliner in black. Again, this was another good one to use on the tight line, is how I would use that, and the Marc Jacobs. Felt like they stayed really good in that area of the eye. Have another beauty sponge. Speaking of Real Techniques, this is one of the Real Techniques ones that I like, and I did buy these in like a pack of like six of them, I think. But I really like these. I think these are not, I forgot what they were meant for, but I like them to tap my foundation on and smooth it out. Then I have a little perfume sample. This is from Louis Vuitton, and this was the rose scent. It smells really good. I just don't think I would want to spend that kind of money on it, but it did smell good. Very nice. And I have this little sample here. This was from Too Faced, and this was the, Primed and Peachy. Anyway, it's their new primer that they just came out with. It was a sample or a code or something. Anyway, I did not like this at all, and this is not empty, but it peeled up so bad. I can't even work with that, so I would say no to that for that reason. And then I have a few sheet masks. Normally I would do these in a separate video, but I only have just a few, so we're going to go ahead and go through them. And this is the Black Pearl mask, and I'm not for sure what brand. Beauty Diaries, I think. I'm not for sure what brand this was from, but anyway, I will figure it out and have it down here for you so that you'll know. But anyway, I do like this brand a mask, even though I can't remember what it's called. This one was probably one of the first masks that I bought when I was first starting masking. I didn't really care for this. This is Face Wraps. It's the avocado and vitamin E. I'm sure I got these from Marshall's or TJ Maxx. These I don't like. I don't like this brand, the cream. And this was in the Pink Lemonade face mask. Use that. And then this one, my friend Annie sent these to me. And this is the Papa Recipe. And this is the Bombay Rose Gold Honey Mask. Oh my gosh, this was so good. Once I get down some more on my mask, I am going to go hog wild and get a bunch of these because I really like them. And, she's got these on Haute Look. So if you shop Haute Look, if you see Korean skincare come up and they have Papa Recipe, grab you some. So anyway, that is it for my empties for the month of October. I hope you enjoyed. Don't forget to give me a big old fat thumbs up, and we'll talk to you soon.